Hello students, another important topic in first module is the dump truck problem. Six dump trucks, as per problem statement, six dump trucks are used to haul coal from entrance of a small mine to the railroad. Okay, here is the diagram of that dump truck problem. Using this diagram you can understand the statement better. Loading takes place simultaneously. Maximum two trucks can be loaded at a time, right? At a time, maximum two trucks can be loaded, and weighing queue, and using weighing queue, only one truck can be sailed. So there are out of six trucks, two trucks can be loaded, and one truck can be weighed. Once the weighing is done, traveling takes place, so truck should reach the destination, okay, unload the things, that is coal, and come back to the loader. So this repeats. So they have given the distribution of loading time for the dump truck. Okay, loading time. So distribution of loading time, weighing time, and travel time is given as an input table. Loading time, there are three probabilities: 5 minutes, 10 minutes, or 15 minutes. Of 30% truck being loaded in 5 minutes, 50% being loaded in 10 minutes, and 20% remaining loaded in 15 minutes. That is what probability is, students. So try to understand. So if your probability is given, cumulative probability and random digit. Observing the random digit is easy. Just go through the numbers 0 to 3. I mean 1 to 3 here. It next is number starts from 4. Last number will be 8. Similarly, for weighing time as well as travel time. So weighing time is either 12 minutes or 16 minutes, and travel time is, there are four possibilities: 40, 60, 80, and 100. And just go through the input table: distribution of travel time, distribution of weighing time, as well as distribution of the loading time. With these statistics, we are supposed to create a simulation table. So to create the simulation table, you have to identify the system state first. So number of trucks in a loader queue, LQ. Okay, at time t, L of t stands for number of trucks, truck ID, being loaded. L of t, it is marked as. Then number of trucks in weighing queue is marked as WQ of t, as well as W of t stands for number of trucks being weighed. That's at a time t. Very simple to understand. Then next is the event notice, and here in event notice, three parameters. Okay. ALQ, comma T, comma DTI, which stands for dump truck I, where I is the truck ID, okay, arrives at loader Q at a time T. ALQ, arrival at loader Q, ALQ stands for arrival at loader Q at a time T by dump truck I is the ID. EL stands for ends of loading. EL stands for end time of loading at time T of dump truck I. And EW stands for end of weighing. EL stands for end of loading. EW stands for end of weighing. That's it. Entities are nothing but six trucks. Each are identified as DT1, DT2 to DT6. Then list, okay, loader queue and weigh queue to be considered. There are two queues here. One is loader queue and other one is weigh queue. That's it. And activities are the three distribution table given. No, they are the activities: loading time, weighing time, and travel time. A delay to be considered in this sense, since there are two queues, so queue delay at queue to be considered: loader queue as well as scaling or weighing queue. So for the problem, simulation table is given. Let us see the simulation table next. So it has been assumed that 5 trucks are at the loader and 1 at scale. Remember, there are 6 trucks. Okay, out of 6, yeah, one truck can be, yeah, this is what the snapshot at time interval 0. What we are considering? We are considering one truck is at weighing, is under scale, and remaining 5 are there at loader. Actually, 2 trucks will be loaded. What are remaining? 3 more. will be at Q actually. Okay, this is what the snapshot. So loading time of the truck, one, it is 10 minutes, its weighing time is given as 12 minutes and travel time is given as 60 minutes. This is from the chart only. Please remember, this is for the from the input table only. So these things are given. Okay, so calculation part let us see later. This is what the simulation table. So in the simulation table, you have to consider, you have to start the simulation at a time interval 0 for the sake of convenience. List out all the system states, 4 states, then list out the loader queue and wake queue. Okay, then FEL is compulsory and cumulative statistics are compulsory. Cumulative statistics are nothing but see BL and BS. So BL stands for total busy time of both the loaders and BS is the total busy time. Cumulative means summation, guys. So total busy time of both loaders from loaders from time to time till T. Okay, BS is the total busy time of the scale from 0 to T. So BL and BS are the cumulative statistics we are considering. At 0, total number of trucks at loader Q will be how much? Loader Q will be 3, 2 trucks being loaded and 1 truck is under weight. This is what from the problem definition. Just now I said you, right? At time T, we have taken the system snapshot and initialization is done in such a way that one truck is being weighed. It is under scale. And there is no question of waiting queue for the first truck itself, right? Two trucks can be loaded simultaneously. So number of trucks under load will be 2. There is no, yeah, of course, there are 3 more trucks remaining should wait in a queue. Then, yeah, truck IDs are identified. DT1 is the first truck. Chronological way we are following. DT2 is the second. DT3 is the third truck. So, DT1 is being weighed. 2 more are being loaded, 2 and 3. Loader queue will contain 3 more trucks, 4, 5 and 6. Wake queue, there is nothing. Future event list to be created. So end of loading, at what time loading ends? Loading ends, you refer from the previous table, you will come to know. This table will tell you about it. For truck